Blackstone Audiobooks presents Europe's Last Summer. Who started the Great War in 1914? By David Fromkin. This book bears the following dedication. For Alain Silvera, a companion along many of life's roads, with thanks for so often pointing me in the right direction. The peremptory transition from an apparently profound peace to violent general war in a few midsummer weeks in 1914 continues to defy attempts at explanation. John Keegan, The First World War. Prologue. 1. Out of the Blue. Shortly after 11 o'clock at night on Sunday, December 29th, 1997, United Airlines Flight 826, a Boeing 747 carrying 374 passengers and 19 crew, was 2 hours into its scheduled trip across the Pacific from Tokyo to Honolulu. It had reached its assigned cruising altitude of between 31,000 and 33,000 feet. Meal service was about to be completed. It had been an uneventful trip. In a terrifying instant, everything changed. The plane was struck without warning by a force that was invisible. The aircraft abruptly nosed up, then it nosed down into a free fall. Screaming bodies were flung about promiscuously, colliding with ceilings and with serving carts. A 32-year-old Japanese woman was killed, and 102 people were injured. Regaining control of the jumbo jet, the captain and cockpit crew guided Flight 826 back to the Japanese airport from which it had taken off hours before. What was so frightening about this episode was its mysteriousness. Until the moment of impact, the flight had been a normal one. There had been no reason to expect that it would be anything else. There had been no warning, no flash of lightning across the sky. You could not see it coming, whatever it may have been. Passengers had no idea what had hit them, and airline companies were in no position to assure the public that something similar would not happen again. Experts quoted by the communications media were of the opinion that Flight 826 had fallen victim to what they called clear air turbulence. They likened this to a horizontal tornado, but one that you could not see. Some of the experts who were interviewed expressed the hope that within a few years some sort of sensing technology would be developed to detect these invisible storms before they struck. Transparency, the public learned from this episode, signifies little. A Pacific sky can rise up in wrath as suddenly as can a Pacific ocean. Something like such an attack of clear air turbulence is supposed by some to have happened in European civilization in 1914, during its passage from the 19th to the 20th century. The world of the 1890s and 1900s had been not unlike our own age, a time of international congresses, disarmament conferences, globalization of the world economy, and schemes to establish some sort of League of Nations to outlaw war. A long stretch of peace and prosperity was expected by the public to go on indefinitely. Instead, the European world abruptly plunged out of control, crashing and exploding into decades of tyranny, world war, and mass murder. What tornado wrecked civilized old Europe and the world it then ruled? In retrospect, it may be less of a mystery than some of those who lived through it imagined. The years 1913 and 1914 were ones of dangers and troubles. There were warning signs in the early decades of the 20th century that catastrophe might well lie ahead. We can see that now, and military and political leaders could see it then. The sky out of which Europe fell was not empty. On the contrary, it was alive with processes and powers. The forces that were to devastate it, nationalism, socialism, imperialism, and the like, had been in motion for a long time. The European world already was buffeted by high winds. It had been traversing dangerous skies for a long time. The captain and the crew had known it, but the passengers, taken completely by surprise, insistently kept asking why had they received no warning. 2. The importance of the question. In the summer of 1914, a war broke out in Europe that then spread to Africa, the Middle East, Asia, the Pacific, and the Americas. Known now, somewhat inaccurately, as the First World War, it ended by becoming in many ways the largest conflict that the planet had ever known. It deserved the name by which it was called at the time, the Great War. To enter the lists, countries of the Earth ranged themselves into one or another.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.